Okay, guys, today we're going to make one of my favorite recipes I make that is actually fairly healthy. Anyway, but first we've got to put on rice because you serve it over rice. Got my handy dandy rice cooker. And what we want to do is, I'm using this wild blend. I thought I would go fancy. I usually use basmati or jasmine or sometimes brown rice, but brown rice can be digestive issues for me. Okay, I got my handy dandy little $9.97 rice cooker. Let's see. We want to do, it's supposed to be equal parts, but I'm going to be honest with you, I'm making a big batch, so we're going to do a double, and I can always save the rice for later. Here is my favorite thing to season things with. Beautiful briny sea, unicorn salt. It's just a combination of salt and spices. And we're going to do partially water and partially vegetable stock. I do not care for chicken stock. It puts a, you know, that bone marrow kind of taste into it. I don't like it. All right. Well, aren't we just complicated? Tell me why it's going to be so complicated. Okay. So we're going to do I do extra. And the rest of this is going in the Creole. I'm making shrimp Creole, by the way. In case you're wondering if I didn't cover that. And I'm running around in a nightshirt. I'm so classy. You know you love me. Me and my railness. Look. Get ready. We got to move this. We got to. Okay, I didn't think this out. Okay, hold on. Okay. Vegetables. I really should get my big food processor out. Okay, we're not going to do the little guy because, yeah, no. Wait. Did it. There we go. Big guy out. Things gonna get loud up in this place. Okay, now. Plug in, please. On. What the? When plugs attack. This recipe is so freaking good, and like I said, pretty healthy. Because it's predominantly vegetables. And it has so many good things in it. Where did I put that? So, first, we've got a lot of celery. Now, see, there is no right or wrong to the measurements here. This is literally just doing what you like, okay? Hello. I'm about to sit down because my back hurts. First, we're going to do onion because we've got to saute that mofo. Just a little bit. Literally just tiny, tiny, tiny bit of oil. Tiny bit. EVOO. Because let's get real. Vegetable oil, whatever, sucks. But worse for you than anything, at least EVOO has some dietary benefits. Still, really, if you want to get truthful, no oil, but you've got to do a little bit of oil for certain veggies. So, what we've got here is a Spanish onion. You can use any kind of onion you like. Okay. I just prefer purple. You know, purple's my favorite color, but that has nothing to do with it. It's just a milder, better taste, in my opinion. I do have some issues with my stomach. So, things like regular onions can be harsh. Okay, here we go. Okay, I'm going to switch you around a little bit so we can see the stove. You're probably going to be able to see me real super well because I'll probably block. But, no. There's some chunks. Here. About a tablespoon or two, maybe that. The queen of the kitchen. Okay, now we got to do our other veggies and a little pre-gaming, and that would be bell pepper, celery, let's see, bell pepper, watch me go savager. I usually use tricolor peppers, but literally was kind of working the budget situation, so we're just doing green today. Though I do love red and yellow and orange. They lend a completely different kind of flavor. But those are like $1.78 each. The green are 88 cents each. So yeah, we're going to stick with just green. Put the pepper and the celery together. Yeah. This is a Cajun recipe, FYI. But kind of my take on it, it's not true to form, really. Celery. Oops, I forgot to move you back here, babies. Celery. And I didn't wash it. I actually kind of like my veggie a little dirty, and it's disgusting. I know, forgive me. They get washed at the freaking place. I mean, it's not like they're totally filthy. So we got our bell pepper and our celery. And we're going on. Come off. some stuff that did not get hard, but we're going to, I mean, did not get squished, but we're going to add those to our other veggies. Yeah, I didn't cut that one, did I? Okay. I'm adding a little magic unicorn salt to the veggies, but you've already seen that, so it's not like I need to show you. This stuff is pure ocean salt, celery salt, rosemary, granulated garlic, and smoked paprika. All the good things in the world. What's next? Me fighting with this thing every time. Let's see, I'm going to put this in here. My leavings. And we've got green onion. Love green onion. Was raised literally eating fresh green onion from my grandmother's garden. Raw. Sounds crazy, but it's true. I loved it. And later, I'm going to make a recipe and post it of, like, the best homemade salsa you could ever make. It does involve one canned item, but it's still awesome. Right now, we're doing shrimp Creole. And what we've got here is cilantro. I usually use parsley, but they did not have any parsley. So, well, no parsley today. I use both. I like cilantro and parsley in there. Lots of herbaceousness. But, nope, the store was not having it today. Okay. Love my herbaceousness. Tomatoes. I like to do a mixture of fresh and canned and fresh tomatoes and tomato sauce. Sometimes I do stewed tomatoes, but today I'm doing tomato sauce because, well, that's just the mood I was in. Usually do lime, but dumb me, forgot lime. Okay, let's go add this into. Got some in there that we're going to use the stock to get the rest of it out. To do both lemon and lime, but like I said, I forgot to grab lime, so it doesn't hurt to not have lime. It's not gonna ruin the recipe. It's really a lot of fluidity to this recipe. You know, the point is getting the basics and the spice. Turn you a little bit this way to towards the stove if I can get it. Okay. And lost a seed in there. Oh well. Forget the bit of juicy goodness from the tomato. Oh, it's all good, baby. It's all good. Okay. Now you can do this with chicken. You can literally just put any vegetable you want in it and not do any kind of protein at all. You could do tofu. I mean, literally, we're talking about this is just a base recipe. You could do whatever you want. Now, it's just that shrimp is pretty traditional for this. And let's turn the temperature down. Put some veggie stock. And where is my lid to my veggie stock? Uh-oh. Oh, I forgot a very important ingredient. Darn it. Garlic. How could I forget garlic? Oh my gosh. You don't understand. That's like a cardinal sin for this recipe. Let's see. I like a lot of garlic. I do both fresh and pre-minced, because it is a lot milder than regular. And of course, it was supposed to go in with the onion, but I did a dumbass move. Pardon my. So we'll get the little guy out for this. Where to put the knife? Okay. Y'all's. Oh wait, I forgot I got a thing to peel now. AliExpress is like magical, man. This is literally just change. It's not gonna hurt to not saute. So, do it. Doing this right now. I need to do it quick. Okay. Sometimes I put a whole freaking head. And I want another one of garlic, but we're not going to do that today because the recipe I'm making is actually smaller than usual. Picking all the crap off of here. And I'm going to also add some of the pre-minced from a jar. Like I said, it's supposed to be raw. It's not. It does have some probably slight cook to it just to keep it bacterial free. World's longest video making this simplest recipe. That's about it. And not even good camera work. But I just wanted to do this because this is one of my favorite recipes to make. It's one of my healthiest recipes that more or less I came up with. I just kind of adapted a traditional Creole recipe. Put my own twist on it over the years. I've been honing it for a couple decades. And it's very tasty with not a ton of unhealthiness to it. And that's always good because most of my really good recipes are so bad for you because I am so southern. Now, there's no such thing as a tasty recipe in the South that is good for you. Because if it's a healthy thing, you know what? Yeah, I want one day to we batter it or bread it or cornmeal it and deep fry it. There we go. Let's turn you back over to the stove a little, guys. Our wheat garlic. See, it's not even the right color to be raw. So, where did I put the lid? Did y'all see where I put the lid? Because it needs to have its lid. Hello? Okay. Now, this seasoning part. I usually use something different, but this is literally the same thing. This is slap your mama. What I usually use is literally called shrimp Creole seasoning, but I mean, there is virtually no difference here. And you do this to taste. I like it spicy. Small shrimp, basically because they tend to be the less likely to have the poop in it, and we're just going for shrimp taste. We're not really going for big old jumbo shrimpies. But first, tomato sauce. I've got 15 ounces here. It's really not a science, you know what I'm saying? Again, to taste. And like I said, sometimes I use stewed tomatoes, sometimes I use a ton of fresh tomato. It just depends on what's going on financially. What am I in the mood for? Having trouble with my can opener. And this just simmers for like, I'd say 30 minutes. Maybe less, maybe more, just depends. When is it done? And I've got 12 ounces of little baby cow shrimp. Go in here. And that's the recipe. You know, when it's done, it's done. When it tastes right, it tastes right. Like I said, there's so much leeway in this recipe. Literally make it however you want. I'm just trying to give you the basic of it. My rice is cooking. Oops. And just, you know, it's wild rice, that's all. You can use any rice you want for that. This is the most freaking forgiving relationship. Well, anyway, I'm gonna leave the stock out because just in case I need more moisture in it. And that's the recipe. Enjoy, guys.